Greetings. This video is about the 3D-WOX1 3D printer from Sindoh. Did a bunch of looking around on the internet and could not find any information in regards to replacing nozzles. This, as you see, is a nozzle cartridge, which is actually very easy to replace. Two connectors, magnetic mount. But the nozzle itself is brass and wears out. And if you want to do any kind of abrasive materials like glass-filled nylon, a brass nozzle really isn't going to do you any good. Couldn't find any information about how to replace that, so doing a little destructive testing, I'm going to find out how to do this on my own. The first thing to note is that this nozzle appears to be glued, sealed, or otherwise bonded in. What I found is that this little silicone shield is glued on, and with a little effort, you can carefully peel it away. I've already done that, so it's loose now. But you can see it was glued in with what looked like red RTV silicone. Save that, we can put that back on. The nozzle itself is threaded into this aluminum block. You can see the heater here, and the temperature sensing element is here. The nozzle is a 7mm nut driver to fit on. Bear in mind, you're going to have to support this block with a backing wrench of some sort. I used a small crescent, but you don't have a whole lot of purchase here. So you're going to have to be very careful because it will twist inside there. Anyway, after that's broke loose, which takes a little bit of effort, the nozzle does come out. And as you can see, it's a little threaded, shouldered brass nozzle. And I believe that these can be found in different materials on the internet. This one here I measured, and it is a 6mm diameter, 1mm thread pitch, and 8mm long from the shoulder to the end. And we're going to go see if we can find something on the internet to replace that with. So it turns out there is a vendor. I found this 6mm nozzle from Micro Swiss, and they call it for a rep wrap type 3D printer, but I found that it's dimensionally equivalent to the one that I have in my Sindoh. So it's a hardened steel, coated, threaded in and retightened. Now I'm just going to have to glue this little silicone back on. You can see where it had been attached prior, and let that cure. So I got the original nozzle pulled out and put that replacement nozzle in, and in taking very careful measurements, I discovered that the length of the nozzles is about 3/1000ths difference, measured from the shoulder of where the filament goes into its collar in the printhead to span to the nozzle tip. Original equipment was 3.253 inches, and this new one is 3.250, difference of 3/1000ths of an inch. And it's about 0.0762 millimeters. However, I discovered that that difference can be made up in the settings in the Sindoh 3D-WOX1 slicer that goes into SolidWorks. So it should be no problem. So the results are in. I had to offset my new nozzle Z-axis by 0.08 millimeters to account for the 3/1000ths difference in depth of the or length of the nozzle. And as you can see here, I just made a little two-layer pass. The initial layer was 9/1000ths, and the following layer was about 8/1000ths, which comes out to the settings, which is what it expected for 0.2 millimeters per pass. So all in all, looks like this aftermarket nozzle works good with the Sindoh printer. And fortunately now we can have some information out there where other people can change their nozzles to other aftermarket materials as opposed to relying on the Sindoh. Thank you for watching.